Hello students, welcome back to the session. In the last session we were talking about the open source concepts, and in this session let us talk about the different terms that we are used in the internet. And the first and the foremost among that is your World Wide Web, in short known as your WWW. So this is a part of the internet and it was launched in 1993. So this web is a way of accessing the information, way of accessing information through the internet. So it is an information sharing model, and this web uses the HTTP protocol, and that is the language spoken over the internet to transmit the data. The web services which uses the HTTP to allow the applications to communicate in order to transact or exchange business logic, and use the web to share the information. And this web uses the browsers such as your Internet Explorer or Firefox, etc., to access the web document. And the web pages of the web document are linked to each other with the hyperlinks. This web documents can also contain graphics, sounds, text and video also. So what are the advantages of this WWW? One of the first advantages is the communication service. Communication service, that is, email is an online correspondence system. So with this email you can send and receive instant electronic messages, that letters. Your messages will be delivered instantly to people anywhere in the world, unlike the traditional post that we post, which may take more time and sometimes it may not be transferred at all, which will not reach at all. So communication service is one of the best advantages of your internet. And accessing of the information, accessing of information at any time, anywhere in the world. So it is a treasure of information. Any kind of information on any topic is available on WWW. The search engines that is present on the internet can help you to find the data on any subject. And another advantage is your online shopping. So online shopping, along with getting the information on the internet, you can also shop online. There are many online stores, sites that can be used to look for the products, as well as you can buy them using your credit cards or debit cards, net banking. You can compare prices with others. There are many online shopping services present. Like your Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal, right? All these are used for your online shopping. And you can also use internet for online chat. So there are chat rooms available on the web that can be accessed to meet the new people. You can make new friends. You can keep in touch with the old friends through this online chatting. And downloading software. So you can download educational softwares, games, music, videos, movies, any other entertainment software that is available from the internet, and most of which will be free. So these are the advantages that you have of using internet. In the same way, we will have the disadvantages also. So what are the disadvantages that you have? So disadvantages we can say leak of personal information, disadvantages is leak of information. That is, when we are talking about information, we say personal information. So there's a chance that your personal information, like your names, address, phone numbers, it can be accessed by other people. If you use a credit card to shop online, then your credit card information may be stolen. So these are the this is one of the major disadvantage. And also a very serious issue, that is when it comes to the young children. There are many videos which may not be, which you are not supposed to view, which are not good to watch. So all these can be seen by the younger children, which is not good. These are also a serious concern while you are using your internet. What to see, what not to see, which is good for the younger children, which is not, which is bad for the younger children, right? And then you have your spamming. Spamming means it refers, that is, you are sending emails in bulk, which is not necessary. Unnecessarily, you are sending the same files again and again. It serves no purpose and it is unnecessarily, it occupies the space in the system also. And one another is your virus threat. Virus threat is the one of the most common problems in internet. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of your internet. But the major advantages of the web includes time, that is, any time it can be accessed, and it brings the entire world to your doorstep, and different types of works can be performed as per the requirements of the user. Other advantages, may advantages are a bit more compared to the disadvantages. And as we said, WWW, World Wide Web Consortium, W3C, we say it is the main international standards organization. And this World Wide Web was found and it was led by Tim Berners-Lee. Okay. And one another advantage, or you can say the different term that we are using in internet, is your telnet. So it is a network protocol. Again, as we had told earlier, protocol is nothing but the rules. So it is a network protocols that is used on the internet or LANs also to provide a bi-directional interactive text-oriented communication facility. So telnet means establishing a connection with the telnet protocol, either with the command line client or a program interface. It provides, it gives access, it provides access to a command line interface on a remote host. Most network equipment and operating systems with a TCP/IP support this telnet service for remote configuration. The next term is your web browser. So web browser, it is a software application for retrieving, presenting and transferring the information resources on the World Wide Web. It is a software application used for retrieving, presenting and transferring the information resources on the World Wide Web. So information is identified by a URL. This will be identified by a URL, that is your uniform resource locator, or can also call it as an identifier. And this may be a web page, image, video or any other piece contains information. So the hyperlinks present in the information helps the users to navigate their browsers to the related resources. So when you are saying URL, it gives you the address, resource locator or identifier, URI. It gives you the address as to where that information is present. And next you have your web server. Web server, it is a high-speed computer that enables a website to be viewed and processes the requests by the clients using the HTTP. So web server is a high-speed computer that enables a website to be viewed and processes the requests by the clients using HTTP. So HTTP, as you already know, HTTP means Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So it's a key for transferring the data on the web. When you want to view a particular website, you type the URL. When we are saying URL, as we said, HTTP, and you go on continue, right? So www dot. So this is what you mean by your URL. And the primary function of a web server is to store, process, and deliver the web pages to the clients. And the communication between the client and the server takes place using the Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The pages that you are delivered, contains HTML documents that may contain images, style sheets, scripts in addition to the text content. And the next term is your web page. So web page is a part of the document, web document, that is suitable for your World Wide Web and the web browser. Again, it contains text, pictures, videos, etc. So web browser displays a web page on a monitor, or it may be a mobile device also. And again, the web page is designed using markup languages like HTML. And the next term is your domain. So it is a domain is a unique name. Domain name is a unique name that identifies an internet resource like your website. It is an identification string that defines the administrative control authority or control on the internet. The domain names are formed by the rules of the domain name system, that we call it as a DNS. DNS means domain name system. Any name registered in the DNS is a domain name. So the functional descriptions of the domain names will be presented in the domain name system article. And next you have the URLs and domain name. So URLs and domain name. Now for example, as we say HTTP, you have www.cmp.com. In this, cmp.com is the domain name. Is the domain name, and anything after that, it is used to identify the specific contents that is present in that site. And the URL, that is your HTTP, tells the computer what language or protocol to use when communicating with the website. The website normally use the HTTP protocol. So this symbol, whatever you have, it just separates the protocol from the rest of the address. And this symbol, this, he indicates that a connection is being made, attempted. So many URLs have www at the beginning. It is just another level of the domain name. It's also known as a subdomain, but from a server standpoint, it is not actually necessary. And next you have the ISP or Internet Service Provider. So this is an organization that provides services for accessing, using, or participating in the internet. So internet service providers, they may be organized in various forms. It may be commercial, community owned, non-profit, or otherwise it may be privately owned also. So internet services that is provided by the ISPs include the internet access, internet transit, domain name registration, web hosting, etc. So the rest, next is your internet server. So internet server internet server. So it is a network of computers with millions of computers linked together that covers the entire world or the globe. So we do not know how many people are there or computers are linked to the internet, but it's very huge. So this internet server, it is a special computer which is constantly or continuously switched on and connected to the internet, so that each internet user around the world can access the website at all times. It is built with a selected high quality components which can work with high speed and high load. Some of the popular web servers are like Apache server, Microsoft ISS, Google, all those are your internet servers. The software packages also can be used for this. So in general, internet server is a special computer. It is a special computer which is constantly switched on and connected to the internet, so that each internet user around the world can access your website at all times. So it is built with a high quality component. This is about your internet server. And the next part that we have is e-commerce. So what is this e-commerce? I think we'll finish. This is the last part we have in the e-commerce. Let us finish this, and so that we can finish the chapter. So what is e-commerce? E-commerce is nothing but electronic commerce. E-commerce is nothing but electronic commerce. That is a subset of the e-business. It's a purchasing, selling and exchanging of goods. Electronic commerce used for purchasing, selling and exchanging of goods or services over the internet. So what are the advantages that you have of your e-commerce? Advantages is an organization can expand its market to national and international markets. That is your national, can reach national and international markets with minimum investment. And it improves the brand image of the company. It improves the brand image of the company. It helps to simplify the business processes and makes them faster and efficient. And also it reduces the paperwork. So, and also it is 24/7. So you can do the transactions 24/7. So that is the advantages. And also it provides more options for the user. You have many options that we can do. Quick delivery of products is also one of the advantages. So shall we continue with this? I think let us stop here with the advantages and continue in the next session.